Labdien, ļoti.
Hello, dear representatives of media, all of you who follow us in online in Latvia, in Japan and other places of the world. Today we have the official visit of His Excellency Ministry of Foreign Affairs for Japan, Mr. Toshimito Motegi. He is welcomed by the Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Latvia, by Edgars Rinkevich, and it is happening during this historical visit of 100 years anniversary of our friendship relationship. Dear colleagues, today I am very happy to welcome the Foreign Minister of Japan, Mr. Toshimito Motegi. This visit is very symbolic because today we celebrate 100 years anniversary of establishing of diplomatic relationship. However, we are not talking only about the history, we also celebrate our close relationship, but we also discussed a lot how to develop our cooperation in future. I have to say that 100 years ago and also now, we share common values, we share common understanding about the principles and values in international politics. We also currently see a lot of things like-minded, whether it's human rights, international rights observation, the rule of law, and thus we agreed to continue our close political dialogue, both in the governmental and ministerial level, also to closely develop economic cooperation. I have to say that we talked a lot about bilateral economical cooperation. I would really like to see companies of Japan to participate in the projects of Rail Baltic development project. I'm very happy to see that the investments of Japan in the economy of Latvia grow in important sectors. We also talked about cooperation in digital sphere, and I have to say that a lot of Latvian companies already closely cooperate with Japan. Of course, we also discussed regional situation here in Ukraine, in Belarus. We are very thankful to Japan for its understanding in participation in G7. We also discussed a lot of issues concerning Northern Korea and the situation in the Asia-Pacific region. And I have to say that we completely agree on those challenges and on the way to deal with these challenges. Of course, the EU, Japan, and United Nations relationship, regional cooperation, cooperation in the form of Green Alliance and climate changes is what we see as a future way of cooperation. And finally, I have to say that quite soon in Tokyo, Olympic and Paralympic Games will start. Of course, we support you and we, of course, support our teams. Nevertheless, these games will happen in quite a challenging situation, and we are more certain that despite all challenges placed to us by COVID-19 to our team, to team to JAPA, will nevertheless give success to both our teams. So I wish success to our friends and colleagues in Japan, and I would like to hope that our further relationship of next 100 years will be dynamic, will be very active, will be very friendful and fruitful. Thank you. Thank you. And now I give the floor to Minister of Foreign Affairs of Japan. He will speak in Japanese, but there will be interpretation.
え、日ラトビア友好100周年の節目に、日本の外務大臣として、史上初となる、ラトビア訪問実現できたことを、嬉しく思います。自由、民主主義、人権、法の支配といった、基本的価値を共有するラトビアは、 日本の重要なパートナーであります。日本は100年前にラトビアの国家承認を最初に行った5カ国の一つでした。ラトビアの独立回復からこの30年、日本とラトビアは2007年の天皇皇后両陛下ご訪問や2018年の安倍総理の訪問を含め、政治経済、科学技術、文化、スポーツなどあらゆる分野で関係を発展させてきました。そして今後、関係発展の可能性はさらに大きい、そのように考えております。
通訳あります。I am delighted to make this visit to Latvia for the first time ever as the Minister for Foreign Affairs of Japan at the milestone of the 100th anniversary of friendship between Japan and Latvia. In Latvia, which shares fundamental values such as freedom, democracy, human rights, and the rule of law, is a crucial partner for Japan. Japan was one of the first countries to give state recognition to Latvia 100 years ago.In the last 30 years since Latvia's restoration of independence, Japan and Latvia have developed relations in every field, such as politics, economy, science and technology, culture and sports, including the visit of Their Majesties the Emperor and Empress in 2007, as well as Prime Minister Abe's visit in 2018.And I am confident that the possibilities for future cooperation and to expand on our relationship is here too.
本日、カリンシュ首相を表敬するとともに、リンケビッチ外相と充実した意見交換を行い、日ラトビア外相共同声明も発出したしました。良好な二国間関係を一層強化していくことを確認できたことを嬉しく思います。特に経済関係をさらに強化すべく協力していくことで一致をいたしました。
Today, I paid a courtesy call on Prime Minister Karinch and had a fruitful exchange of views with Foreign Minister Rinkevich, where we issued the Japan-Latvia Foreign Minister's joint statement. I am pleased that we confirmed to further strengthen the excellent bilateral relations, and in particular, we agreed to further enhance economic relations.
すでにラトビアの重要な天然ガス輸送貯蔵運営事業に日本企業が参画をしております。またバルト三国の欧州大陸電力ネットワークへの接続事業に日本企業は協力しています。ラトビアを含むバルト三国の欧州統合強化に資する広域インフラ事業に高い技術力を持つ日本企業はさらに貢献できることを期待をいたしております。
And already, a Japanese company is participating in Latvia's crucial project for natural gas transmission and storage operations project. And moreover, Japanese companies are cooperating in the project to connect Baltic states to the continental European network. And I hope that Japanese companies,with technological advantages, will be able to further contribute to the wide area infrastructure projects that contribute to the strengthening of European integration in the three Baltic states, including Latvia.
インド太平洋についても議論しました。本年1月、私が日本の外務大臣として初めて EU 外務理事会に出席し、説明をしました。自由で開かれてインド太平洋についての日本の考え方や取り組みも踏まえ、4月に発表されたインド太平洋における協力のための EU 戦略を、EU のインド太平洋への関与の強い意思として歓迎しています。本日、リンケービッチ外相から、日本が推進する自由で開かれたインド太平洋の実現に向けたラトビアの力強い支持をいただきました。
We also discussed the Indo-Pacific.Japan welcomes the EU strategy for cooperation in the Indo-Pacific announced in April, which took into account, among other matters, Japan's views and efforts regarding a free and open Indo-Pacific, which I outlined in the EU Foreign Affairs Council in January this year, being the first Japanese foreign minister to attend. This strategy is a sign of the strong will of the EU to engage in the Indo-Pacific.Today, Minister Rinkevich gave the strong support of Estonia to bring about a free and open Indo-Pacific promoted by Japan.
地域情勢についても意見交換を行い、東シナ海、南シナ海での一方的な現状変更の試みの継続強化や、海警法、香港、新疆の状況について深刻な懸念を共有し、基本的価値を共有する同志国が結束して、ルールに基づく自由で開かれた国際秩序を維持・強化していくことの重要性について一致をいたしました。
We also exchanged views on regional situations and shared serious concerns over continued and enhanced unilateral attempts to change the status quo in the East and South China Seas, the Coast Guard law, the situation in Hong Kong and Xinjiang, and agreed on the importance of like-minded countries that share fundamental values to come together in solidarity to maintain and strengthen a free and open, rules-based international order.
さらに北朝鮮のすべての大量破壊兵器及びあらゆる射程の弾道ミサイルの CVID に向け、安保理決議の完全な履行が不可欠であることを確認するとともに、拉致問題の即時解決に支持をいただいたところであります。
Furthermore, we confirmed that the full implementation of relevant Security Council resolutions is indispensable for the CVID of all of North Korea's weapons of mass destruction and ballistic missiles of all ranges, and received a support for the immediate resolution of the abductions issue.
また、欧州地域情勢や、日本とラトビアの間で今、協力が非常にうまくいっている、国際上における協力についても意見交換を行いました。さらに、3週間後に迫った、東京オリンピック・パラリンピック大会について、ラトビアから温かい、力強いご支持をいただきました。ラトビアの選手が、東京オリンピック・パラリンピックにおいても、大活躍されることを期待をいたしております。
We also exchanged views on the regional situations in Europe and on the cooperation in the international arena, which is going very well between our two countries. And in 3 weeks' time, Japan will host the Tokyo Olympic and Paralympic Games. And Minister Rinkevich gave the very warm and robust support of Latvia to the Tokyo Games.And I do wish for the great success of the athletes, the Latvian athletes, to participate in the Olympic and Paralympic Games.
今回、温かく迎えてくださったリンケービッチ外相にはじめ、ラトビアの皆さんに改めて感謝をいたします。今回の私の訪問を契機に、両国の関係、さまざまな分野で一層緊密化するように取り組んでいきたいと思います。
I would like to thank Foreign Minister Rinkevich and for the people of Latvia for warmly welcoming me. And taking this opportunity of my visit, I will work to further strengthen the relationship between the two countries in various areas.
Thank you very much.
Lielas paldies. Ar to arī noslēdzam ministru paziņojumu.
Thank you. With this, we conclude our communication to mass media.